everybody, my name is Tamires Gama, and then I'm really honored to be here to talk about something that I really like, which is online teaching. So today we're going to be demystifying online teaching, and I hope that you can get some tips on how to start your online business and how to transition from the face-to-face class to the online one. But first, I'd like to introduce myself by showing you some pictures. I hope you can guess what it is. So first, I was born and raised in Osasco. If you haven't paid a visit to Osasco, you definitely should. Osasco is known as the capital of hot dogs, and I'm really passionate about my city. Therefore, there are many pigeons. I'm not so passionate about them, but if you come to Osasco, you will see we have lots of them. Something that I'd like to share with you as well is I run my own business. So I've been an online teacher for 4 years, but 2018 was a watershed in my career because I decided to work exclusively online. So I started offering my lessons, and then I started growing my business as an online teacher. And today I'm gonna share some ups and downs that I've had when I first started, because I didn't have much information about how to offer my lessons and then which platforms I could use. So I hope that by the end of this video, you can feel a bit more empowered to start working online. And today we're going to be talking about hardware, software, and liveware. I consider these 3 points the holy trinity of the online teaching. And for a start, we're going to start talking about hardware and software. Moving on a bit, we're going to be talking about liveware, which is the human factor. And then I'd like to consider the teacher's perspective and the student's perspective. But before moving on, there's something that I usually ask the teachers that take courses with me. Why? Why are you thinking about transitioning from the face-to-face environment to the online one? So you need to have a clear objective when you first take this step. Are you gonna transition to the face-to-face environment, to the online one, because you were made redundant, or because you are a bit tired of commuting, or even if you wanna start a school, an online school? So you should have a clear goal. Otherwise, there are many challenges, but if you don't have a clear goal, you may get lost. And then sometimes it can be a bit daunting at first when you start teaching online, because you need to get up to speed with platforms, ways to charge for classes, and many things to consider as well. But my first piece of advice, it is to begin. Online teaching, it is still teaching, so you're gonna find yourself a bit more stretched in terms of new activities, or even the way you're going to deliver your lessons. So it's really challenging, but it is really rewarding as well. So let's get down to business. I'd like to share some tips on hardware. The first thing that comes to our minds when we are talking about hardware, it is the computer, the mouse, it is the equipment you're gonna use to deliver your lessons. I have to confess that when I first started teaching, I didn't have a computer because I was a bit broke. So my computer didn't have a built-in camera, and I couldn't afford buying a new one. So what I did was I placed my cell phone in front of me. There was a mirror behind it. And then when I started teaching online, I used WhatsApp. I know that's not a good thing, but it was a way for me to teach my lessons. And it was not comfortable because I felt like a failure because my student, she was paying for the lessons, but I didn't have the proper equipment. So the first thing to consider is, how are you going to deliver your lessons? Are you going to use your tablet? I don't recommend, but what about your computer? Do you have a computer that has a built-in camera? Or are you going to, do you need to buy a new one? Today, I brought for us some tips on equipment. Things that I consider important is camera, lighting, and your mic. As for a camera, today I'm using a camera, this one. These high definition camera from Logitech. They offer different kinds of cameras. This one, I've done some research, and it is the one that was more suitable for my computer. There are some computers that do not accept this camera, such as MacBooks. So you need to try to take a look at it. There is a MacBook that is not compatible for this camera. So you should, before you make a decision, check what is the version of your computer, and then if this camera is going to be suitable. I would say, in terms of price, it costs 300 reais, but when I bought it, it was about Black Friday, so I paid 250 reais for this one. The best, I would say this one is the most interesting in terms of recording lessons. Moving on to lightning. What I'm using today, it is this ring light. You can go to 25 de Março if you live in São Paulo, or you can order it at Mercado Livre. I paid less than 100 reais for this one, but if you don't want to invest in lightning like this, you can use the sunlight. I know that's not the reality for many teachers, because I sometimes teach at night. So what I usually, what I did when I first started, I bought this very simple light from Kamunga. Okay, you can order it online. And then I paid at about 29 reais. It makes some difference. So you will see, if I turn off my ring light, that's what you get. Because I have the window open, it doesn't make much difference. But you see, there's some light. Something else regarding lightning and camera that I forgot to mention was this. If you have a built-in camera, that's not a problem. But you will see how different it looks if I use my built-in camera from my computer. I'm gonna turn it off a second. Do you see how different I look? So the problem, there isn't a problem if you start with this kind of camera, but it does make some difference. So there is also an advantage, which is this camera from Logitech, it comes with a built-in mic. So you don't need to buy a mic at first. I might confess that this mic is not so good, but it is a way for you to start offering your lessons online. Moving on to mic. I'd like to share good and bad experience that I had, which was about this mic over here from Sony. This one. This was microfone de lapela. I paid 194 reais and it was not compatible for my computer. So I spent some money and then I couldn't get a refund for this. This microphone is good if you're going to record with your cell phone. So if you're offering your classes online, I wouldn't buy this one. Many teachers, they ask me, Tami, do I have to buy many things at first? No, you don't. Just focus on what's more important to you, and then little by little you aim to make some investments. So if you're thinking about buying a headset, you can buy this one that I really recommend. This one is from Logitech as well. Logitech offers lots of great products for online teaching and for audiovisual as well. This one, I'm gonna put some information about it by the end of the presentation, but this one, it isolates the sound, which is something useful as well. If you have some kids at home, if your neighbors are kind of noisy, so it just isolates the sound around me. Moving on to software, I'd like to share with you the things that I've implemented in my lessons, and then that I really continue doing because I believe they're really useful for my students. And it is a way for you to sell your classes as well. Well, regarding video conferencing, my favorite one nowadays, it is Zoom. But when I first started, I used Skype. What I suggest is, you can take a look at Zoom tutorials. I'll show you what they look like. And then I'd like to share with you some of the functionalities that I found really useful when using Zoom. First, My students can have access to my board. There is a button that I can share my control with the student. So if I have planned a drag and drop activity, if I have planned an activity where they have to type in the answers, they can do it by using my control. I can also share the sound with my students. So that's really useful if you are playing a video with them. So this is the greatest tool, I would say. You can also have it on Skype, but sometimes I had experienced many problems with that. So the sound was too low, my students couldn't hear it. So Zooming is perfect for sharing sound and sharing your screen. Besides your screen share options, it is mobile friendly. Some of my students, if they need to, if there's any problem with their computer, they can use their phones to have the lesson. It is not the perfect scenario, but I would say as for a backup plan, it helps a lot. And you can also have some annotations. Your students can use your screen to annotate. There are many videos about how you can do, how you can use these functionalities. So if you, I really recommend you take a look at the Zoom website for that. And many teachers have asked me, do you use a board? Do you have a computer program for that? If you are using Zoom, Zoom offers a whiteboard. I'm going to show it. Then for this board, you're going to have some options where you can find a pen, a pencil, some squares, some stamps. Your students can write on the board. So it's really useful if you are providing feedback. Nowadays, what I use with my students is the board from the Active Inspire program. This is a program that you can download to your computer, and then it is a whiteboard. You can have many buttons where you can have some shapes, and then you can click, you can copy and paste some pictures. It is really helpful. So nowadays, what I do is I use Zoom as my video conferencing program. I click on share screen, and the screen my students see, it is my board from Active Inspire. I'll leave the link at the end of our presentation so you can take a look at how to install Active Inspire for your computer. Another option, if you don't want to download a computer program, you can use the free board from Google Jamboard. It works pretty much the same. It is a whiteboard where you can have some post-its for your students. You can copy and paste pictures. Your learners can have access to the document as well. Because what I do for Active Inspire is, it is possible to export the files as a PDF. So my learners, they receive the annotations from the board as a PDF. One of my suggestions, if you are thinking about starting your business as an online teacher, it is to consider, how are my learners going to see their production? Or how am I going to store my students' production? Or how am I going to send my students the files they need to use? What I use nowadays, it is Google Classroom. What I did was, my students, they receive a link because I have created a classroom for them. Don't worry about lots of information now about Google Classroom, because you can take a look at it. There are many tutorials teaching you how to create a classroom, how to create assignments, and then how to post the material, how to post the question. I would like to share with you how I organize my Google Classroom nowadays. My students, they have three or four main folders where I post grammar support, materials for them to take a look at, some areas they need more improvement, homework, and class notes. These class notes, they are the lessons that we had together. So whenever I finish my lesson, I export the files as a PDF and I upload them to the Google Classroom. So my learners, they have access to everything that I posted on the board. So my annotations, the exercises, even if they have the book. Nowadays, I have been using a book from Macmillan. My learners buy this book, but I have the access to the digital book So my students have the book, and I also have the book on the page for them. I adapt to lots of activities from the book, but my learners, they have the material. I tell them that I don't sell the material. They have to find it by themselves. So it helps if you have decided on a book which it is a bit more computer friendly, I would say, because there are many materials nowadays that they don't offer the student's book in the digital version for the teacher. And last but not least, I consider Liveware one of the most important parts in online teaching. Online teaching is still teaching. I'm going to repeat it throughout the videos because many teachers ask me as if online teaching was something very different from the teaching that we usually do. It is different. We have some particularities, but it is still teaching. So you really need to cater for your learners' needs. You have to take into account their difficulties and how you're going to offer them these lessons. So in order to get a better use of the Liveware factor in online teaching, I have some suggestions. So let's take a look at it. Something that I find really useful when I'm teaching online, it is to bring my own personality to the lesson. So what I brought to you today, there are two backgrounds that I usually use with my students. Because I use the Active Inspire board, I can copy and paste some images from the internet, and then my students, they have this background sometimes. So whenever I welcome them to the lesson, I say, so please have a seat, let's pretend we are in a talk show. So my students, they like it. It's like the element of fun. So try to bring your own personality. So what I usually do is, whenever I welcome them to the class, I have a specific background for that. And when I'm providing feedback, I have this board-like picture. So they have some elements from the face-to-face environment brought to the online one. I'm sure they're gonna love it. Another important thing to take into account, it is netiquette. I don't know if you have heard about it, but from day zero, when my students, they come from the trial lesson, I tell them the rules. So nowadays I have a guide. So whenever a prospect gets in touch with me, I send them the information about the course and some rules. For instance, my students, they can cancel the lessons, but they can cancel within a 24-hour gap. So if my students cancel before 24 hours, they have the right to have this lesson. If they don't, I'm so sorry, they cannot have the lesson. So you need to establish this ground rule so you feel more comfortable as a teacher and your learners respect you more. Because when you don't have rules, they believe they can do anything. Some learners believe that because we are teaching at home, we are available 24/7. So I tell my students the time that I'm gonna answer them, the days I'm available, when they can have the substitutive lessons. If they don't know, they're gonna think you're available 24/7. And then I struggled when I first started because I didn't have a guide for my students. So they didn't know how to treat me because I didn't teach them. So it's a learner training. Learner training is of the essence for this part. And I'd like to leave you with some suggestions on courses you can take. There are some free courses offered, such as this from Cambridge Assessment English. This was the first one that I took two years ago. And it was really helpful because it taught me how to take into account some details when teaching online. There's another course, this one that I've just finished. It is Learning to Teach Online, amazing course. You can take it for free or you can pay to get the certificate. I really recommend it because they talk about different kinds of online environments. They offer, actually they provide the students with examples from teachers from history classes, from extension courses, graduation courses, so I would recommend you taking a look at this one as well. And I'd really like to thank you all for being here today. Even though you started really small, I didn't have a business plan, and then I consider myself a very successful teacher because I love what I do. I feel that my students, they are learning, and it's really rewarding. So even though I started small, I've always thought big about my business and then how to help more teachers and how to help more students to learn English. So if you do have any question, you can, let's keep in touch. You can send me a message. I'll leave my Instagram and then my email. If you want to know more about online teaching, if you want to know more about courses for teachers, count on me. I'll be around, okay? Thank you very much. I hope you have a great semester, and then hope to see you soon.